Here comes a new year, and for many of us, a renewed interest in looking not just good, but amazing. And there's some brand new clinical studies out that prove you can roll back up to 3 years of aging in just 8 weeks. I'm gonna tell you what that means for you and your skin in today's video. Well, hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. If you're new and you're not familiar with who I am, I'm Chris. I'm a skincare expert, been doing this for 34 years. Yeah, and my job is to help you find skincare that will work for you, not into your wallet, and not do you more harm than good. So if that sounds like something you'd be interested in here on YouTube, please be sure and subscribe. Hit the little notification bell so that you know when my new videos are out every week. Now, who does not want to roll back the clock on how we look? I mean, most everybody does, at least after 30. And we know that things like eating well, staying fit, and getting enough rest all make a big difference. And as we head into the new year, as I said, there's always a renewed interest in looking better and feeling better. Maybe it's losing some weight or what have you. But today we're gonna talk about some scientific ways you can actually take 3 years off your biological age and the look of your skin in just 8 weeks. Now, as I said, these new studies that are out prove once again that things like diet, exercise, mindfulness, skincare routines, the products that you use on your face, all can combine to create a perfect storm of wellness. How often do we get to say perfect storm of wellness? All of these things don't just slow the aging process, they actually help reverse it. Now, I will put a link to the Health Got studies down in the video description box. If you guys want to go read the full studies, you can do that. They're there for you. Suffice it to say, we're going to be going over the very things you can start doing right now that 8 weeks from today, if you started today, that's just barely into the new year, you're going to look and feel different. Now, the reason all of these things are effective is because they address ongoing inflammation and the methylation of your cells. DNA methylation is not something that we have talked about a whole lot on the channel. It's kind of one of those really scientific terms that sounds really scary, but it is a naturally occurring process in the body that helps it operate. It has to do with regulating gene expression, to get really scientific. But on the positive side, it does things like help regulate cell production by making sure that our cells are being healthily replicated. And on the negative side, when it gets out of hand or goes awry, it can cause things like cancer. All right, so what do you need to be doing? Well, first and foremost, let's talk about diet. I'm not gonna spend a whole lot of time on diet because I've got videos on this on the channel, which I will link to in the video description box. But if you have a diet that is high in sugar, in this 8 week plan, it would be a really good idea to cut a lot of that refined sugar out. Now, I know, it's the holidays, I'm with you, but if you can do it, it can really make a big difference, and here's why. We know that sugar impacts the body negatively. We know about diabetes. I'm not gonna spend a lot of time going over all the illnesses that sugar can play a part in creating, but when it comes to skin and organ health, we know that too much sugar in the body oxidizes, latches onto cells, weakens cell walls, creates havoc in your collagen production, not just in your skin, but in your organs, and can lead to premature aging inside and out. So too much sugar is a real problem, and it's one of the things in your diet you can change in this 8 weeks that can lead to a big difference on down the line. Add to this, of course, I'm going to tell you to beef up the leafy greens in your diet, to add supplements like collagen proteins and vitamin K2 with D3, because we know those things help the body operate better, helps calcium distribution, nutrient and oxygen distribution throughout the body to your cells, which makes healthier cells as we generate them. Now, the other thing I want to touch on is, of course, activity. A sedentary lifestyle is not doing any of us any good. It's one of the things that I beat my own drum at myself about, making sure that I'm active during the week. You guys know I film a lot of videos. I spend a ton of time on my arse editing these things, and I have my watch, my smartwatch, remind me it's time to get up off my butt. Here's why that's important. Studies have actually shown that just 3 days a week of 30 minutes of just moderate exercise, walking, swimming, running, playing fetch with the dog or your significant other, whichever way you want to do it, Those things help your body produce healthier cells at all levels. It helps reduce the damage and shortening span of your telomeres, which leads to premature cell death. I know I'm being very medical with you guys today, and I normally am not, but I want you to understand the why these things are important. So certainly you don't need to become a gym rat. I'm not one, but I keep my fitness as a priority for me because I feel better, I have more energy to do what I need to do, and I want to live healthy as I get older. So it's very, very important to make sure you have some sort of activity plan throughout the week to keep you from being sedentary. It's going to make a big difference. And again, in 8 weeks, you're going to be able to measure that. Certainly, jogging is fine. Certainly, lifting light weights. Again, you don't need to be a gym rat. We just need to get off our butts and move. The other thing that has been shown to make a huge difference in the aging process for our bodies and our skin is making sure that we get relaxation. Now, normally I preach about getting enough sleep, 6 to 8 hours a day. You guys know that follow me. I'm not going to talk about sleep today. That's a given. But I'm talking about unplugging from everything, putting your social media away, getting off the television, off the computer, off the phone, whatever you have going on, for 15 to 20 minutes. 30 minutes is even better, of just shutting it all off and just focusing on maybe a fan in the room, or if you're out in nature, just watching nature, staring at the leaves on a tree. What we want to do is defocus the mind from outside stimuli to internal stimuli. So a lot of people use breathing techniques. That's absolutely fine. But that mindfulness session resets a lot of things in your body. It also really reduces the amount of inflammation that goes on in your body during the day. Kind of gives that reset to you before you have your nighttime reset where you're actually sleeping. It makes a big, big difference. I know it's one of the things that when I get so busy that I forget or stop doing that, I can really tell the difference in my mood, my mental clarity, and my physical energy. So give that a try. Again, 8 weeks, and look and see what it does for you. And of course, this is a skincare channel, and I'm a skincare guy. So we're going to talk about skincare routines. This is a great time of year. It's a great reason, this 8-week plan, to take a look at and reevaluate your skincare routine. Now, there are tons of new products on the market today. There are tons of ingredients we have covered on the channel. It would take us an hour to go through all of those. So again, I will link to my skincare routine videos. If you guys want to watch those, I highly recommend it. But here are some basics. You want to look at that face wash, depending on where you live in the world, it's summer or it's winter, whatever, and make sure that your face wash is working well for you. What that means is it's cleansing your skin, leaving it hydrated, not squeaky tight. If your skin feels extra dry or extra tight after you use a face wash, it's not the right face wash for you, and you need to bump up to a creamy version that is going to have less of an effect on the pH on your skin and be very gentle to the cleansing process. The next thing is to make sure you have a vitamin C serum in your skincare routine, whether that's the stronger L-ascorbic acid versions like the Ordinary's 23% suspension that I talk about, or a drugstore product like Olay or CeraVe or one of those vitamin C serums that is made with sodium ascorbyl phosphate, which is much milder for sensitive skin. Either way, we want that antioxidant working on our skin to help ward off any problems that we get from the toxins in the air and from when we touch our face, and to help brighten that complexion and speed up that cellular turnover. So vitamin C serum, one of those main things, I think I just spit, sorry. Vitamin C serum, one of the main things that you really need to have in a basic skincare routine that's gonna make a difference in that 8 weeks. On top of that, we wanna make sure that we are giving our skin what it needs in the form of support for collagen. One of the ways to do that is to make sure that we are using a collagen peptide product. You guys know I talk about the Inky List Collagen Booster on this channel a lot. It's one of my favorite products. So it can be very helpful in replacing those amino acids that we produce less of as we get older to support collagen production. Now, I'm going to be mentioning a few products here in this skincare routine. I will link to those, like I always do, down below in the video description box, and you will be able to find the links that you're looking for. Next in this routine, to help roll back 3 years and 8 weeks, we want to make sure we have an exfoliation step in place for our skin. Now, you can do this physically with a scrub. I don't really recommend those for the most part. They're too rough on skin, especially facial skin, but there are some sugar scrubs out there that are okay. Or a product like a Buff Puff Gentle, which is a sponge that's designed to help remove dead skin cells that are stuck to the surface of our skin, making it look dull and making fine lines and wrinkles look worse. Or you can use a skin exfoliating acid like Alpha Skincare's 14% Renewal Serum that I use and talk about on the channel. That's a glycolic acid that helps loosen the bond between the old skin cells stuck on the surface and the new skin underneath. It can really make a big difference in the smoothness and freshness of your skin. You can also use a peel product once or twice a week that's made of these same types of acids. There's the Olay Mask Vitamin C and AHA peel that I talk about on the channel. Again, I'll link to that below. Also, I like the Ordinary's peel solution with the glycolic salicylic acid mix that goes on the skin 2 to 3 times a week. It goes deeper into the skin and allows that old skin to slough off pretty quickly and pretty easily. It can make a big difference over time in the way your skin looks and feels. And then, of course, in the routine, as I always talk about, for most of you, it's going to be important, especially if you're over 30, to be using a retinol moisturizer. Now, I know there is a lot of conjecture out there about retinols and the strength of retinols. And I have, again, videos on that that I will put down below for you to watch, full videos. But as a general rule, for a healthier skin, to help reverse sun damage and really boost collagen production over time, which is going to get rid of hyperpigmentation, age spots, fine lines and wrinkles, is going to help plump those out and just give you thicker skin overall, a retinol product is the way to go. It is still the number one topical that can do these things for your skin. And then, of course, and most perhaps importantly, is that you wear sunscreen. So important for two reasons. One, you need to protect your skin from further accumulating damage from the sun for a whole variety of reasons, from photo aging to skin cancer risks. So yes, we want to protect our skin from any further damage. It's going to allow our products to work better. But here's the other reason that people don't think about. When your skin is not having to expend energy, and it does, to protect itself from the sun, when you do not have sunscreen on, that same energy goes back into the healing and replication process of your cells in your skin, and it's going to make a big difference over time. So not only does it protect your skin now, it helps you roll back the clock. Do these things for the next 8 weeks. Take a selfie when you start, take a selfie when you stop, put the two together, and just be amazed at how different you feel and look. And I want you to come back to this video in the comments or on the Skin So Fabulous blog and let me know how this worked out for you. Now, I hope this video was helpful today and get you guys kind of revved up and motivated for what's ahead in the new year. If it was helpful, please give it a like, share it out, and again, let me know in the comments how it works for you. Thank you guys so much for supporting the channel this year. You know how much I appreciate it. I know you have a choice here on YouTube. Thank you for choosing me. Love you guys. Stay beautiful, and I will see you over on the next video. Got a skincare question you want answered? Just type Chris Gibson and the topic in the YouTube search bar, and the video will come up.